So, and this particular tool, it basically helps investigate what are those issues apart from the material flows, which then helps us look into or understand the situation of what the SFD is representing. I mean, like an SFD will be helpful to us to tell us that, okay, 60% of my waste is going into the open environment due to the lack of infrastructure. But then the CSDA then looks into a further step down and looks into the underlying policies and institutional and the regulatory setup, and then tells us, and this particular tool also then helps us understand what the next steps should be, or what the cities, how the cities should go about developing a policy or having an institutional structure in place. And this particular tool is available on the fsmtoolbox.com. So I'll just give you a quick snapshot of what the tool looks like. So this is the fsmtoolbox.com. Once, if it's open source, it's accessible for anybody. You can just come in and sign up on the platform, and you will be, you will have access to all the tools. Now coming to the city service delivery assessment tool, it asks you, and I think Mantrana in the last session also mentioned something with respect to the what kind of data do we need, right? So I'll just give you a very quick glimpse of what are the data points that is required. And you just enter the basic information about a city. And then once you click on the next button, it will ask you the, it goes on to asking you, does your city has a sewerage network or not? And in case it does not have a sewerage network, then does it have plans for building or implementing sewerage network in the future or not? Then according to whatever is your city's context, whether you are looking forward to a sewerage sanitation or looking forward or only planning to do non-sewerage sanitation improvements, depending on that, it has few set of questions. So it has 24 questions for sewage sanitation, and it has 24 questions for non-sewage sanitation. And then it, all the questions are related to very simple policy level or planning and budgeting related. Like, for example, is there a provision for, is there a policy provision for sewerage services in the city or not, or across the city or not? And most of the times, available at a national or a local level policy, right? I mean, like most of the times, oftentimes the questions that are embedded into the platform may not be exactly relevant for you. And that is where, like, for example, policy may be applicable. Like, we have the policy at a national level, the septic management policy, as well as we have state operative guidelines. And depending on what is relevant for the city, if a state operative guidelines are much more relevant, then the tool also gives you option to edit it. And depending on the whether it's a state level or a local level or a national level policy guideline, you can edit the questions and then fill out the answers based on that. So zero being the not available or whether it's in a very poor condition. 0.5 is a medium where the policy is in a draft stage maybe, or it is available, but it is not widely acknowledged and widely known, or as a, or only exists as a guideline. And then the first one would be the policy is very appropriate, it's well enforced and into practice. So depending on whatever is relevant for the city, you can choose these options. And then once you fill out all of these questions, and depending on what is the most relevant for your city, the tool then also helps you provide a output, like the ready-made output is provided, where it will give you this for every action point, be it, or for the every thematic area, be it the policy or be it the budget or be it whether it is inclusion or funding related questions. So for all the questions, it provides you a overall scenario of where you are currently looking at and what are the primary actions that you can take to further improve the situation. For example, like the immediate primary action with respect to a policy is that there are no norms. As you mentioned that there are no norms, then the standards and the public health standards for public health and the environmental protection should be applied at a local level. So it also tells you whether the action, whether the primary actions or the interim or the long-term actions are applicable at a local level or at a national level. So this is the tool. It basically sums up all the action points across all the different thematic areas. with respect to the enabling ecosystem, with respect to the policies, with respect to the regulations and other institutional capacities and the other services that is being provided. You can also then download the report in a PDF format, which is available to you for further dissemination or further usage or discussing with the within the stakeholders. Now, this particular tool or this particular exercise is usually done by a third party, but then the major idea is to have consultations with different stakeholders. Now, the different stakeholders might have different perspectives on different aspects or different thematic areas. For example, a desurging operator in the city might give a completely different perspective than a city engineer, and the city engineer might have a different perspective than a house than the households. So it is usual, like it's very well done when you have those stakeholder consultations in process. And then you come up and fill out this the scoring that we just saw. So this particular tool then helps you give a much more realistic picture on where the city should improve actions on the non-material flows of it, or the softer components, as we call it. So that is with respect to the city service delivery assessment tool.